What's up, friend? Chris Krohn here. Today we are going to be talking about buying abandoned properties. Frankly, they can be some of the best investments out there if you do it right. So I'm going to talk about where to find them, and then when you do, what do you actually do with them so that you can actually buy it when there's no contact sign? Because we're going to be legends. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary. Why would you actually want to buy abandoned property in the first place? You know, I wondered the same thing until it became one of my next deals. There was this property fairly close to the train tracks. It was a small little 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom home, and frankly, a total dump. People hadn't put love and care into that property for a long time. And when I saw it, it was actually listed as a short sale, which means that the bank actually hadn't totally finished the foreclosure process. They wanted to get it off their books, and they listed it. And all of a sudden there were hundreds of offers on this property because it was a really good, it wasn't the best location, but it was a really great price. And I knew enough about short sales to put my offer in at the right time. 9 months earlier, they had listed it. We waited until literally the day before the bank was gonna do the review, found out what was on all the other offers, and then we put in the best offer. On this abandoned piece of property that ended up actually being bank owned in this situation, I ended up securing the bid, buying the property, got a fantastic price. It took a lot of money to fix it up. I probably put close to $20,000 into this particular property, got it fully fixed up, and I held this home for a number of years. Had really great tenants, always had an easy time leasing it out, made great cash flow on it, and by the time I sold it, I made not a little bit of money. Like, it worked out really well. So I learned that abandoned properties can absolutely be a great source of investments. So why you would want to buy an abandoned property is that ultimately it means that the person no longer cares about the property. Either the property is like boarded up when you drive around and you find them, or the grass has been grown really tall so they're not doing any active landscaping on it. Or you can just look at it, looks like it hasn't had a decent paint job in a really long period of time, might have broken windows. Any of those things can basically mean, all right, this is a property that someone owns, whether it's a bank or a human, and they obviously don't care about it because it's in horrible condition, which means that it's a little bit of a crapshoot. Maybe they're keeping that home because they inherited it and grandma used to live there and they made a deal to never sell it. But more often than not, they're just too busy focusing on other things. This thing has become an eyesore. And if you can find a way to get in touch with them, it could be the source of an amazing deal. Now, good deals do not always turn out the right way. Small cautionary tale for you here. I had bought a home in Orem. It was a 3-bedroom, 1-bath, and it was over a century old. And I got a fantastic deal on this house. But I want to tell you something. I spent more money fixing that property up than probably almost any other property. And when I got tenants in it, it was constant complaining of this not working and that not working. The whole electrical system was like dated back to literally like probably 60, 70 years earlier. All the copper in it, there was problems with it and parts of it were eroding. I held that property for 5 painful years. And when I finally sold it, I think at the end of the day, I made a few $1,000. The amount of time and attention and caring costs, that was a horrible investment. It really didn't learn out. By the way, I learned a rule along the way about buying really old homes, and that when things are really dated, the kind of costs and problems that can show up with them, tremendous. Abandoned is not always necessarily a good thing. You still got to have your standards. Here's the more important thing though that I think you need to be thinking about. When you buy an abandoned property, you're essentially saying, I think I can get a good deal this way, and if I can, it means that I'm willing to roll up my sleeves or have someone roll up their sleeves and go to Home Depot 38 times. Someone's gonna have to fix this up. Someone's gonna have to actually get this up to code and bring it into good condition. Abandoned property doesn't always mean that it's dilapidated, but it often does. It means you're really looking for a fixer-upper. Now, these days, I don't do fixer-uppers anymore. I only do lipstick, which basically means, you know, cosmetic makeup on a property, maybe paint and carpet, and usually not anything else behind that. So if you find one of these, you're really signing up for a lot of work. There's a reason why I don't do them anymore. You could actually click the link below and get a copy of my book. It was the first book I wrote. I just had it updated. It's called The Straight Path to Real Estate Wealth, and makes an argument for the best way of transacting real estate. It doesn't include abandoned properties, but if you want to find one, the best way is to talk to the postman and garbage man and other individuals that are actually out there driving the streets all day long. They know where the abandoned properties are. And you could pay them $100 for a tip, or just ask them and maybe they'll tell you, or you could just get in your car and drive around. That's how you find these. You can look up the address on county records and it's public information who it belongs to. And so you can get an address, often a phone number, and with a little bit of Dr. Googling, you can actually find out who owns the property and get in contact with it. The bigger question is, just because you can fix something up, does it mean that you want to? In the beginning, the answer was absolutely yes. Now, having done enough projects, the answer is absolutely heck no, I'm definitely not going to do that, because I found that there's an easier way. Hence, I wrote this book to actually share exactly what that way is. By the way, this book is free. You just cover shipping. And I always print enough extra copies that I can get it in the mail. And we have an excess of them right now. So if you want to get a copy of this book will save you millions and make you millions, so you don't monkey around with doing the wrong things in real estate. This is like an A to Z step-by-step guide of how to make your first $1 million. Hey, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope that it helped answer the question and really share with you why these happen, where you can find these properties, and ultimately how to get the contact information to make it happen. At the end of the day, I've learned that there are easier ways of doing real estate, and for every deal you can find that is distressed, I can find a really good deal that's not, which means a lot less time, a lot less money, a lot less work, and potentially make a lot more money. So if that's of interest to you, get my book for free. It's just down in the link below. And other than that, if you're not, please be a subscriber. I make these videos each and every day for your benefit, and they cover everything in the gamut of real estate and business to help you become as successful financially as you possibly can. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching the video. We'll see you tomorrow.